Hello friend, welcome all of you to the Electric Neuron. Today we are going to see another new topic that are related to the network theory, which are very important to your examination like SSC, Railway Gate and ESC. So before starting our video lectures, I want to tell you that if you like the video, then share to your friend and also subscribe to this channel so that you will get immediate notification whenever I will upload a new video. Okay, so let's get started. So in this topic we are going to see the star and delta conversion and delta star conversion. So before starting our star delta conversion and delta star conversion, we need to know the basic network that are related to our star delta conversion and delta star conversion. So see here, this is the pi model of the network. The resistance R1 and resistance R2, resistance R3 are connected to this network. So here Vi is the input voltage and Vo is the output voltage. So this figure is shown like the T model, so it is called as a T network. Okay, so another network, that is pi network. So this is Ra resistance with Rb and Rc resistance are connected in parallel manner with V input as input voltage and Vo as our output voltage. Okay, so this is the pi like structure, that's why it is called as pi network. Okay, so there is another term or another figure, that is star. Okay, so this is the star like structure. There is one node in between the resistance R1, R2 and R3. Okay, so this is a star like structure, that why it is called as a star network. Like that, there is one new type, that is delta network. So it is like triangle Ra, Rb, Rc resistance. Okay, so it is Ra phase, Rb phase, Rc phase. So it is our delta network. Now all the basic term are related to this we are discuss here. Now we will see about the delta to star conversion. Star conversion. Okay, so this is our delta figure and this is your star figure. So how it will be converted from the delta figure to star figure? Let's see. I am drawing here. Okay, so this is your Ra resistance, this is your Ra resistance and this is your Rb resistance and this is your Rc resistance. So we need to convert that figure to our star network, that means this network. Okay, this is your R1 resistance, R2 resistance and R3 resistance. So we need to find the R1 value, R2 value and R3 value. Okay, so here convert this delta network to star network. So this is your R1, this is your R2 and this is your R3. So for R1 value there is one formula. So if you want to find the value of R1, then multiply the connected resistance at that node. So Ra into Rb divided by at the denominator side, add all the resistance of delta network, that is Ra plus Rb plus Rc. Okay, and for R2 resistance, so nearby resistance connected to that R2 resistance at that node, that is Rb and Rc. So multiply Rb into Rc. At the denominator, add all the resistance connected in the delta network, then you will form Ra plus Rb plus Rc. Like that, for R3 case, multiply the resistance connected at the node of R3, that is array into RC, array into RC divided by total resistance, that is RA plus RB plus RC. Okay, so this is the formula to how to find the resistance value of that delta network from the delta to star conversion, that is symbol like this. Okay, so this is the formula. If you want to find, now see the conversion of star to delta network. Okay, this is our second step. And okay, so see here, this is the star connected network, figures on like this. This is the A phase and this is B phase, wait, this is the C phase. Okay, and the resistance R1, R2 and R3. So we need to transform this star network to delta network. So first make this network as your delta network. Okay, let this resistance is RA and this resistance is RB and this resistance is RC. So if you want to find the resistance RA, that means this is the resistance RA and this is your resistance RB and this is your resistance RC. So if you want to find the resistance value RA, then multiply the resistance value R1 into R2, then add R2 into R3, then add R3 into R1. Okay, and then divide the opposite term resistance, that means R2. Okay, like that, in all the cases, if you want to find the resistance value across the RB, that means this value. So at the numerator case, as like as your previous case, this is also same, R1 into R2 plus R2 into R3 plus R3 into R1 divided by opposite arm resistance, that is R3. So divided by R3, like that you have to find the RC value. So this is the conversion of star to delta and delta to star network. So for today, that's it. Thank you for watching.